The Chief Health Officer has declared Victoria won't see 300 daily cases again on his watch. The bold prediction was made as we recorded a minor uptick in infections and a COVID outbreak shut down the Masked Singer. Dougal Beattie reports.
Despite the faces of mystery contestants covered, the Masked Singer proved even reality TV isn't immune to the reach of coronavirus.
This is a wildly infectious virus, and even if you've got the very best protocols in place, you will see positive cases.
Seven dancers on the show have tested positive. The Docklands studio today shut down as the entire production team forced to isolate, including its high-profile panel of judges. The show given the go-ahead under Stage 4 restrictions.
The determination's been made around broad sectors that are considered essential, and television is one of those.
208 new cases were recorded in Victoria today, up 26 on yesterday. With four reclassified, it brings the total number to 18,231.
So the numbers are bouncing around a little bit, but we're not going to see, you know, 300s and 400s again in Victoria, not under my watch at least.
Despite the slight uptick, the number of active cases also continues to fall, down 281 to 4,012. Hospitalisations have dropped below 600 to 585, and total patients in intensive care has fallen to 32. The Chief Health Officer hopeful the active numbers could be an overrepresentation.
So I think the true active case figure might be more in the 3,500 range.
The state's death toll has now passed 400, rising to 415. There were 17 new deaths, 11 were linked to aged care. Among them, a man and woman in their 60s, three men in their 70s, six men and four women in their 80s, and two men in their 90s.
None of us should be numb to these things. None of this should not become anything other than a statement of tragedy.
Among those planning a funeral is Rodney Thomas from Bendigo. His mother Ruth died in Queensland on Wednesday.
I've considered all options of swimming across rivers to get there just to see my mum and say goodbye for the last time, but I won't do that.
Late this afternoon, the Queensland government agreed to fast-track his application. As tough moments requiring comfort are still a long way off.
At some point, perhaps in the future, we may reach a point where we would see hugging again, but not at this point in time.
And the latest mobility data has revealed that lockdown fatigue has taken hold, with visits to parks up 12% during Stage 4 as Victorians tire of staying indoors.
I'm keen to get out of it, you know, as soon as possible.
We can't be focused on one Saturday at the park. We've got to defeat this thing so that people can spend every Saturday at the park.
The government also launching a new website urging Victorians to support local producers.
The whole state is at your fingertips, so choose Victorian.
All right, let's go live now to Dougal, who's at the Peter McCallum Cancer Centre. Dougal, an investigation is underway into an outbreak there.
Yeah, despite the daily case numbers going down, clusters keep emerging. One is on a ward at the Peter McCallum Cancer Centre. We're told it involves three cases. Two staff members and one patient have tested positive. There are also another outbreak at Estia Health in Keysborough that involves 12 cases. Princeton View Aged Care Facility in Brighton has 10 cases. And two staff members at the Western Private Hospital in Footscray have also contracted the virus. Now, the state government has conducted a thorough analysis of how this virus is spreading amongst healthcare workers, and that plan is set to be released later this week. Alicia?
Okay, Dougal Beattie there, thank you. La Trobe University students have crammed a dorm room for an illegal party on campus, violating strict health guidelines. Video of the midnight gathering was uploaded to social media but quickly deleted. Reid Budler has the story.
The video lasts only a few seconds. But it's crystal clear an illegal party is underway.
Anytime we see people making really poor choices and not following the rules is obviously a concern to us, because that compromises bringing these numbers down.
The gathering happened in student accommodation at La Trobe University in Bundoora.
It's just not smart.
The party would have gone undetected, but one of the guests uploaded this clip to social media around midnight before quickly deleting it. Victoria Police is aware, and La Trobe says it will be investigating, telling Nine News in a statement, the university is concerned to receive footage which appears to show the public health requirements have not been met. We would be very disappointed if this alleged incident did occur, as we've made it very clear to residents they must comply with public health requirements.
We don't want anybody to be breaking the rules. And you know, sadly, we've seen young people die of coronavirus. This idea that young people are somehow immune from this virus is just wrong.
Melburnians made the most of their hour outside today despite less than favourable weather, but not everyone was masked up. Of the 199 fines handed out in the past 24 hours, 20 were for failing to wear a face covering. 73 people copped a penalty for breaching curfew. Among those nabbed, a man caught leaving a Glen Eira petrol station after curfew. He told officers he was buying chocolate for his diabetic friend with low blood sugar. That was a lie. He'd actually just bought cigarettes. A group of five was found drinking together at a home on the Mornington Peninsula, and an Altona Meadows man was pulled over in Brimbank. He told police he was aware of restrictions but got bored at home.
I don't want the bad choices of a small number of people to detract from the amazing work that the vast majority, and I think a growing number of Victorians, are doing.
Now, while fines for COVID-19 breaches are flying thick and fast, parking fines are few and far between. We've learned today that the government has issued a stern directive to every metropolitan council demanding that they only issue parking fines if they're considered essential. That is for vehicles that are proving to be a safety hazard or blocking private property or businesses or parked in a disabled spot without the appropriate permit. The councils where parking inspectors have been put on notice include here in Boroondara, Moreland, Darabin, Yarra, Stonington and the City of Melbourne, which we first reported last week. As for that, a legal party at La Trobe University, Alicia, Victoria Police have just told me that they have started a full investigation and will be following up with targeted patrols.
OK, Reid Butler, thank you.